I'm late for work, of course the car won't start. The brand new VCR just fell apart. I meet my boss with ketchup on my pants. My wife announces she wants more romance. But does the odd catastrophe amaze me? Oh no, mere cataclysm doesn't faze me. I get up tomorrow morning, take a deep breath, and go on. When problems come my way, as well they must, I'm proud to say I know how to adjust. My 10-year-old's best friend is smoking pot. The roof will cost a grand I haven't got. My daughter says the acting bug just bit her. My teenage son is sleeping with the sitter. I get up tomorrow morning, make a great big bull shot, drink it, and go on. And then, of course, there's my amazing wife. That mystery woman tied to me for life. I never know who'll greet me at my house. The broker of the month or Minnie Mouse. She says she loves her job and I believe her. And then she takes this class and she's this weaver. I get up tomorrow morning, say the past is prelude. Stay loose, drop a quaalude. I think that I am rather brave for smiling as I near an early grave. But I do not want points for having hope. I have this little trick that helps me cope. It isn't avant-garde or even trendy. It's just this one man's modus operandi. No matter how my stomach may be churning, or what new lesson I'm again relearning, I get up tomorrow morning, take a hot bath, do my